Hello guys, and welcome back to a new video here at Architects 3DP. Today, as a lot of you have been asking for, we're gonna make an in-depth review of a laser that we unboxed a few weeks ago, and this time it's provided by TWOTREES. The laser that we are going to review today is the TWOTREES TS2 10 watts laser engraver, together with their silent air pump and their honeycomb working table. So placing all the components on the table, first we have the metallic sheet to protect the table surface, the honeycomb working table, their very silent air pump that I'm going to place right here, and finally the TWOTREES TS2 laser machine itself. Now we'll connect the air pump to the network, remove the cap at the back, test if it works, and connect it to the pipe that goes to the laser nozzle. Once the pump is connected, next step is going to be to connect the laser itself right here on the left hand side of the electronics box. And once done, we'll rotate the emergency button to turn it on. You will immediately notice a considerable noise coming from the laser head fan that will keep the laser cool. Alright, so coming to its best features, first of all, we have to talk about this quite big working area. This laser has the biggest working area of all the lasers we have unboxed in the channel that are quite a lot. It has a 450x450mm working area that is reached thanks to its NEMA 17 stepper motors. Normally, all lasers have two motors, one for the X and one for the Y axis. In this case, the TWOTREES TS2 has three motors, since in this case the machine has a real autofocus mechanic system in the Z axis or the laser head. The TWOTREES TS2 does not only have autofocus in the Z axis, this machine has end stops in the X and Y axis as well, so we'll be able to make a complete auto home. Once the laser knows where the 0, X and Y is, we'll be able to move the laser head to any point in the XY space, thanks to, for example, the GRBL free software. As you can see, all the movements are made very silent. The only thing you can hear is the cooling fan at the laser module. This is possible thanks to its 32-bit motherboard, which allows it to have more cool security features, such as horizontal gyroscope that will stop the laser work if it detects any movement or drop of the machine, as well as a flame sensor near the laser nozzle that will stop the print if any flame is detected. It also has a smart auto power off function, as well as, believe it or not, maybe the coolest feature of them all, that is the red emergency stop button. You will use it more often than you think, and it's really nice to have it. I think every single laser in the market should always have it. Remember that as extras for the tests on this video, we also have the air assist pump that we have right here and is adjustable in power, as well as the honeycomb cutting table that will increase your laser work quality a lot, as you can see in the last video we made clicking here in the top right corner. Alright guys, so once everything is connected and ready to work, we're going to make our first test with the TWOTREES TS2 Laser Engraver and Cutter. But that's gonna be after I introduce to you our great channel sponsor that is no other than PCBWay. PCBWay is your website to not only get your PC prototypes the easy way, but also other services such as 3D printing or CNC machining. Today I have some good news in that area, since at PCBWay they have made an in-depth cooperation with FreeCAD, the open source parametric 3D modeler that I'm sure a lot of you use. Now, once you finish your design in FreeCAD, you can place an order on PCBWay with just one click. To use this service, you just have to go to Tools and Add-on Manager, choose PCBWay from the selection list and click Install. To find more information, please check out the link down in the description. Alright guys, so back to the TWOTREES TS2 laser engraver, you have to know that you will have three ways of controlling it. The first and more direct one will be via GRBL or laser burn, connecting the laser to the computer via USB. For the other ways of controlling the machine, you will have to connect it to your Wi-Fi using the provided programs on the SD card. Once you get all the configuration done, you will be able to use the machine, apart from the typical USB cable connected to a PC, via web control, as well as using it with their smartphone app that is available for both Android and iOS. We'll make a test of the machine controlling it with the phone, but first, let's start from the beginning. In the product manual, there is a very cool table that indicates the configuration we'll need to set for different materials and works, for engraving and cutting. We're going to start with an easy material, that is going to be this thin green cardboard. We want to cut it, so according to the table of materials, the most approximate material is playwood 1 to 3 mm. So we're going to set the first test, setting the max speed of 600 mm per minute at 100% power with a single pass. So once the material is loaded, we'll move the laser head to the top of the material and we're going to make the autofocus. Once done, we'll use the framing feature and we'll start with the cutting work. Notice that you will have to import the custom buttons and autofocus buttons to the Laser GRBL software to be able to use those features. You will find the instructions of how to do it in the SD card. Now that the border is cut, I'm going to cut a little bit more difficult figure inside that I downloaded from the internet and it's gonna look very cool. As you can see, it is just using too much power at 600 mm per minute speed, since I think it could be cut much faster. For the second test, I'm going to let the power at 100% and I'm going to set the cutting speed to the double, 1200 mm per minute, and check out how it goes. As you can see now, the cut is much faster and it's perfectly cutting through with no problem. Once finished, as you can see, the laser work finished successfully as well as before, what means that we're going to increase even more the speed for this third test, and for that I'm going to increase the speed to 300 mm per minute. As you can see now, it's cutting perfectly through the cardboard with ease, which is a complete success. I'm sure we could go even faster with this material, but I'm not going to make more tests now, since we need to test more materials today. Here we have, as you can see, our three Mandalorian perfectly cut. As you have seen, guys, this test was actually too easy for this 10-watt laser engraver, right? Now we're going to jump to this thicker 1 mm cardboard that, if we compare it with the previous green one, is considerably thicker. Alright, so as we did before, we'll first make the autofocus to cut this 1 mm material. Now we'll make the auto home and we'll frame the new work. Starting to cut this material, I started to have some issues with the machine, all of them caused by the fire alarm. Because if you actually have a look at the laser end, it is actually starting a fire. And the fire alarm will stop the work. I was using the recommended settings from the table of 260 mm per minute and 100% power. However, it seemed not to be working. I started a third attempt and I was watching some fire at the laser point, until I realized I did not have turned on the air pump assist. So exactly at this point, I turned it on to the max, and as you can see, the flame disappeared, and I was able to finish the cut work with ease. Once finished, I'll remove the excess material, and I'm going to focus the laser for an engraving work. I'm going to start it, and I will see you at the end. As you have seen, the engraving work has been a complete success. We have engraved this really complex drawing, and as you can see, the quality is very high. We use the recommended 6000 mm per minute and 50% power. And maybe it was too much for this material, since if you have a look at the places with more lines density, we actually go through the material as you can see from the back. Are you ready for a new material jump? We're going to jump from this thick cardboard to this 5 mm plywood, that in theory is less than the max thickness that this laser is able to cut in a single pass, according to the manufacturer, 8 mm. That is something that we're going to test right now. So first we'll make the autofocus, frame the work, and I'm going to make a new engraving with the same settings that we used before. As you can see, the engraving worked, turned out just fantastic, so no problem with engraving plywood. Remember that we used the 6000 mm per minute and 50% power for this work. And we're going to change these settings for the cut work, as you can see here, to 150 mm per minute and 100% power in a single pass. So after framing the work area and focusing the laser for the cut, we're going to go ahead and start the cutting work. And as you can see, the fire alarm started one more time and the work stopped. This time, I did not forget to turn on the air compressor and seems more like a material or machine issue. So I started the machine and continued the work. And a few seconds later, the alarm jumped again. And again. And again. Then I decided to start to work in a different area of the wood. And as you can see, the flame was there. And the fire alarm stopped the work one more time. Starting a new job, as you can see, the wood is completely burned. And if you have a look at the laser head, you can really see the flame that is burning the wood completely. The truth is that I got very frustrated and decided to change to another material, just in case this material that I had laying around was not optimal for laser cutting. So I went ahead and I jumped to this 10mm spine wood that I had laying around. As you can see, no flames appear this time, and it's cutting just fine. So I went back to the 5mm plywood. This time I wanted to cut simple shapes, just a couple circles, just to check out if it was able to cut through the wood, and as you can see, one more time, fire alarm. With my frustration going up, I decided to jump down to a 3mm basswood included with one of the lasers we reviewed in the channel, and starting cutting it using the same settings. As you can see, it did cut through absolutely perfectly. Now I have stacked two sheets of 3mm plywood, one on top of each other, and tried the same settings we were using with the plywood to check out if it works in a thicker section. As you can see, it did cut through the first wood as well as through the second, which did almost completely cut through despite the wood is quite burned inside. In theory, if we have been able to cut through the two 3mm sheets of basswood that makes a total of 6mm, we should be able to cut through a single 5mm wood slab, right? But as I was completely annoyed with the fire with the 5mm plywood, I decided to try a new material. In this case, this piece of wood that is actually used for floating wood floors, and it's made of DM or medium density wood. Since the material is more dense, I set the power to 100% and reduced the speed down to 100mm per minute to check out if we were able to cut through. As you can see, the cutting work was successfully working, until suddenly, how not, the fire alarm started beeping and the cutting work stopped. I restarted the work, but one more time, the fire alarm. Test after test, I was getting more upset with the woods, so I decided now to test the 2mm black acrylic included with the machine. So I set the speed and power according to the instructions and started cutting the Mandalorian we cut at the beginning in the green thin cardboard. As you can see, everything was working perfectly, when suddenly the fire alarm started beeping one more time, even with the acrylic. I thought that maybe this fire alarm was caused because of the high density of lines, so I went ahead and cut the frame of this Mandalorian image, that is basically a straight cut with four corners. When it finished, as you can see, the laser did not cut through completely with the given parameters to cut 3mm acrylic. Thinking that maybe it was because of the protective paper, I went ahead and repeated the cut, this time without the paper. And as you can see, it marked the cut at the bottom, but did not completely pass through the material, as you can see here. So I reduced the speed even more to 100mm per minute and repeated the cut. As you can see now, the laser seems to be cutting through the black acrylic like butter. And now yes, a complete success. As a conclusion, we can see that the materials table is not very optimized, and you should make some tests with your machine before going directly for your laser works, destroying your materials as I did. Now I'm going to make another test, and I'm going to engrave this stainless steel tag. So we'll set it in place, autofocus the laser for the engraving work, and go ahead and start the engraving process. As you can see, I think we got a complete success, but anyways, I will make a second pass to see if we can increase the depth of the engraving. As you can see now, the quality after the second pass is very good, maybe the same as in the first pass, but be careful because this piece of metal is pretty hot. After letting it cool down for a while, here we have our laser engraving work that looks just fantastic. Now that we have tested a lot of materials, guys, I think it's time to get it working with our phone, isn't it? So after configuring everything with the laser and connecting it to the Wi-Fi, here we have the app already connected. As you can see, we can move the laser module and more cool stuff. We can choose in between a set of materials to make different engravings, as you can see here. And you can even create your own drawings to engrave in your machine. I'm going to quickly sketch a symbol here, just to check out how it works. So after finishing the drawing, we'll choose in between the different options here at the bottom. We'll connect the machine, set the size, laser speed and power, and when we are done, we can first frame the engraving work, and once ready, we can click on start here at the bottom right corner. I got several errors, so I decided to take out and insert again the microSD card to the laser. It immediately worked, and the engraving work started. After quite a long time, here we have our engraving work completely finished and seems to be even the same size than in the font, what is really cool. Now I'm going to make one of the example shapes included in the app. So I'm going to choose this motorbike and this time making only the contour. So after framing the work, we'll start the engraving. In the app screen, you can watch the progress of the work, as well as the coordinates of the machine, laser power and speed. Once the work is finished, it seems that we did not choose a good speed and power configuration for this engraving work. So I went ahead and increased the power, reduced the speed, and after a couple seconds, how not, fire alarm. Which means that I got more burnt than the materials that we are testing, and I'm jumping to a new material. In this case, I'm going to test this transparent acrylic that I had laying around to check out if it works. So after having focused the laser and started the work, how not, fire alarm. More than being cut, looks like the plastic was being burnt at the top surface. I'm trying to paint it black, so maybe the laser is able to cut through the surface. But we didn't get any better results, so I decided to do something. After becoming crazy with the fire alarm, I have investigated on the internet and found out the possibility to turn down the sensitivity of the fire sensor of the machine. For that, we'll go to the back of the laser head and we'll remove the two bolts holding the sensor in place. Once removed, we'll be able to change the sensibility using the screw right here. So after reducing it a little bit, we'll put the cover back in place and we'll be ready to continue with the tests. So back to the infernal burning wood, I started a new engraving job with the machine that worked out perfectly. Now with a new cut work, the machine didn't stop because of the fire alarm, but I was actually able to see the fire coming out of the laser spot. And how not, it did not cut through completely with a single pass. As you can see cutting this circle, the wood gets completely burned and the laser is not able to cut through completely. I decided to come down to the side of the board to check out if we were able to cut through the wood in two passes, and as you can see we did, but the wood got completely burnt. After changing some of the parameters and making different tests, we did not get any better results. The wood kept getting burnt every time. Check out this star, guys. It got literally on fire, as you can see here. It's at this point when I decided to turn the sensibility of the fire alarm sensor back to its original position and contacted TWOTREES and told them what was happening with the machine. They sent me some instructions to update the firmware of the machine to solve this problem. So I done it, and here we are 1 week later to check out how it works. Also, I found on the internet that increasing the speed of the laser and increasing the number of passes will help us cutting through the wood without burning it, as it was happening to us lately. So after being made all the firmware refresh and so on, I got rid of the table of materials for the instructions and set the cutting parameters with 100 mm per minute speed, a 100% power and 5 passes. And with this configuration and no fire at all, guys, check out the result we got out of the machine. A complete success. So after finally getting some success with this 5 mm plywood, I went ahead and made another laser cut job with this same configuration. Once finished, as you can see, we can separate the puzzle pieces with no problem. And here we have them, completely separated from the wood slab. Despite they are the same piece, they plug in just perfectly, what is really cool to see after this long video. To finish, please make sure you are subscribed to the channel, consider supporting my work on Patreon, as all these amazing people does, and as always, see you in the next video.